Hello viewers, I am Jai Pandit. Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will be discussing MCT, that is MOS controlled thyristor. By the end of this lecture, students will be able to understand structure and working of MCT. MCT, that is MOS controlled thyristor, is a device from the thyristor family. It has the features of thyristor as well as MOSFET. MCT has three terminals, namely gate, anode and cathode. Symbol of MCT is as shown in the figure. MCT is a voltage control device. Unlike all the other devices in the thyristor family, which are current controlled. It has two inbuilt MOSFETs for turning on and turning off operation of the device. Also, MCT is a fully controlled device. This is an exception to the thyristor family, where most of the devices are semi-controlled. Structure of MCT. Basic structure of MCT is as shown in the figure. In the basic structure of MCT, we are having a normal PNPN structure formed over here, that is P, N, P and N structure. Anode terminal is connected to the end P layer and cathode terminal is connected to the end N layer. Here, two FET channels, that is field effect transistor channels, are formed. We are having off FET channel shown over here in the P-type region and on FET channel formed over here in the N-type region. Gate terminal is isolated from the main structure of PNPN pellet by means of SiO2 layer. SiO2, that is silicon dioxide, is used here as an insulator. One of this FET channel is used for turning off operation and another FET channel is used for turning on operation. Unlike all the other devices of thyristor family, the gate voltages are applied with respect to the anode terminal. Working of MCT can be best understood with the help of its equivalent circuit. So let us go to the equivalent circuit of MCT. Figure shows the equivalent circuit of MCT. Here we are having the two transistor circuit of an PNPN structure. Along with that, two MOSFETs are shown over here, which are required for the turning on and turning off operation of the thyristor. First, we'll start with the turn on operation. MCT can be turned on by applying a negative gate voltage to the gate with respect to anode. So if we apply a negative gate voltage over here with respect to the anode, then the same negative voltage will be appearing over here to the gate of on FET, that is पी चैनल मॉस्फेट। इफ द गेट वोल्टेज ऑफ पी चैनल मॉस्फेट इज मेंटेन्ड नेगेटिव विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू इट्स सोर्स देन दिस मॉस्फेट विल टर्न ऑन। वंस दिस मॉस्फेट टर्न्स ऑन द करंट विल स्टार्ट फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम source of this MOSFET to the drain of the MOSFET. This current is supplied to the base terminal of the NPN transistor. Thus, the current will establish emitter current in the NPN transistor. This base to emitter current turns on the NPN transistor and causes the collector current to flow from the NPN transistor. Now this collector current acts as the base current for the PNP transistor. If base current is applied to the PNP transistor, then PNP transistor will also turn on. This regenerative process will continue and both the transistors will turn on. Thus, the PNPN structure will start conducting. Now, let us see the working of MCT for turn-off operation. MCT can be turned off by applying a positive voltage to the gate with respect to cathode. So, let us apply positive voltage to the gate. So, if gate is made positive with respect to that of cathode, with respect to that of anode, then the gate of the off FET will be made positive with respect to its source. If we are making the gate of the off FET positive with respect to the source, this FET will turn on as it is a n-channel FET. Once the off FET is turned on, the anode terminal, which is also the emitter terminal of PNP transistor, will be shorted with the base terminal. Once these two terminals are shorted, the base current in the PNP transistor will tend to reduce. If the base current in the PNP transistor reduces, then the collector current of the PNP transistor will also reduce. Now in this case, the on FET is under the off condition. Hence, the base current supplied to the NPN transistor is the collector current of PNP transistor. If collector current of PNP transistor reduces, eventually the base current of NPN transistor will also reduce. If the base current of NPN transistor reduces, then the NPN transistor will turn off. Eventually, both the transistors will turn off and the PNPN structure will also turn off. Thus, the MCT turns off. Advantages of MCT. The first advantage of MCT is low forward conduction voltage drop. The second advantage is fast switching times. Third advantage, low switching losses. The fourth advantage is high input impedance, which is offered by both the on FET and off FET available in the MCT, because of which the design of the gate drive circuit becomes very, very simple. So, in this discussion, we have seen the structure and working of MCT and also the advantages of MCT. These are the references which we have used for preparing this presentation. If you like this video, please press the like button and subscribe to our channel for more updates. Thank you.